talk fast. You have 1 minute. Cause on a Friday night, me have to tune in to Real Talk on Stars 96 FM. Me and you have questions about love, birds and the bees.
Not to mention the ticks and the fleas.
So you try tuning in on a Friday night between 9 and 12 for Real Talk. At a show we discuss everything real and nothing ID.
It all starts and end in your mind. What you allow will continue. What you give power to has power over you. Welcome, welcome, welcome to Real Talk, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight is the night when we give it to you real and nothing ideal. You're tuned to Styles FM Radio. Of course, you can find that dial on the 96.1. 96.5 and 96.7. I'm your girl, Lady Cleo, holding it down solo-ish tonight. Of course, I have our engineer, very capable engineer, Cassidy, in the building, and I know he will not abandon me tonight. So, welcome to the show, guys. And if you're not yet on, you need to hurry up. And if you know somebody who is not yet tuned in, then of course, tell a friend to tell a friend that Real Talk is on the radio. And we go from now until 12 midnight. So please do stick and stay right here with me. Feel free to share, give your comments, and engage in the discussion as we go through, because guess what? Just maybe something that you'll say or some view that you'll have will be beneficial or helpful to someone else. So stick and stay right here as we not only try to entertain you, but more importantly, educate you on a real level. All right, so again, welcome to Real Talk, guys, and I want your input tonight. I crave your input tonight, so feel free to share as we go through the program. All right, let me just give you those numbers now in case you want to call in and, you know, hook us up later on. If it's your first time, by the way, welcome to Real Talk. Yeah? So the local number is 876-453-1444. That's 876-453-1444. That is, of course, for your text messages and your WhatsApp text messages only and your local calls. If you are overseas and you wish to call in, that number is 954-338-7973. That's 954-338-7973. And, of course, we do have some friends across the world who do listen and watch us via the World Wide Web. So I want to give a shout out to all those social media peeps right about now. And, of course, you know you can see the show afterwards on YouTube, right? I was about to say you can see the show afterwards on Real Talk. But you can see Real Talk afterwards on YouTube. So you check out Styles FM Radio. And I'm not nervous. No, I'm not. So I'm not nervous, Cassidy. All right. Just in case anybody wondering, no. All right. Our Instagram page, you can follow us at Styles FM. On Twitter at Styles FM 961. And for Facebook, which we go live tonight, Cassidy, Facebook Live is up and going and ready. So check out Facebook at Styles FM 96.1. Go to the fan page and you can see me. Me uncle. Me no more. Me solo. Me oh no. Yeah. All right. So, yeah, so we got the social media sites up. Good. And of course, we do have our friends who are on the go in the US of A, Canada, and the United Kingdom. So those peeps are able to listen in on the show as they go. In the USA, the on-the-go number is 712-832-2772. That's 712-832-2772. In the United Kingdom, it's 033-0606-0944. And in Canada, it's 647-957-9637. And as I mentioned, Canada, and remember how cold I've heard that it is in Canada, I realize that the studio kind of feeling like Boston, Massachusetts in December. Yeah, I know what that feels like. And can I tell you, Cassidy, we've been having this cold front, Massa. That is not just cold front, it's cold back, cold side, cold everything. Oh my goodness, have you been cold the last couple of nights? You got an icebox where your heart is, huh? Because, no, you're not supposed to have no icebox where your heart is, brother. Huh. So it's been very, very cold. So all the peeps out there, Mama City, I hope you've been kept warm, whether you have a live blanket or a unlive blanket. I don't know. But once you've been able to keep warm, Mama City, yeah, I hope so. Cydia, good night to you too. Thank you, Cydia. Loving that, loving that. And Marvin, yay, real talk time. I'm here, even though I'm still mourning. At least I have y'all to take my mind. Let me see what Marvin is saying. What happened to Marvin, you know? With friend Marvin. Oh my, take my mind off it. What happened, Marvin, if you can share? I hope it's nothing too tragic, though, Lord. Oh, Lord. Yes. So, those of you who are locked in already, thank you for keeping my company. And I'd love to see history created tonight so I can know that all of those people who are going to be texting in tonight and sharing in with me, Daddy Rude will know that Abe, although he left me alone tonight, the listeners keeping my company. So more of Unus who never normally call in or text in, or try text in tonight, so Daddy Rude can be jealous. Yeah. I know he's listening. Hi, Rude. Uh-huh. We'll talk about this off air. Yes. So Kay is also locked in. Good to have you on tonight, Kay. Good night to you too. And everybody else whose fingers are twitching away at left hand, right hand, just twitching away at the thumb there. Yeah, man. Good to have you on board. Loud ups to Cydia, to Cydia and to Celia as well. Celia Roper. Oh, no. I'm to address that issue. Oh, yes. Celia Johnson, big up yourself. My friend who is always locked in as often as she can, which is pretty much most of the time, yeah? And, of course, to Diane also over there in Atlanta, Georgia. Gary in Bonebrook. Donald, all of Unos. Yes, everybody. I'm not like start calling him still, you know, because, boy, I leave out some people. I say, Lady Shan, they're in Hearty, locked in. Michelle in Snow Hill, you're locked in too, even though, oh my, oh, oh Lord. Can I tell you, let me just address the issue. Kevoy Chambers, I really, really must stop right at this moment. And, you know, honestly, I cried, Cassidy. I'm not personally acquainted with any of the young men, nor the young lady. But I've seen the faces, and just for the fact that these youngsters are young people. That's firstly, they have not really gotten the chance to even live any life in terms of, you know, accomplishing their dreams and desires and going places and, you know, making waves and making their parents proud and all of that. You know, they haven't been able to live. They're like 22. I heard of a 24-year, one of the ages was 24. I'm going to tell you the God Almighty truth. My heart just move. My cry, me just cry. When I saw, you know, the images, boy, I'm going to tell you, no. All of you out there who are mourning the loss of these young men, really, really deepest condolence to you. Not even like a one person passing a man, and one would have been awful, don't get me wrong. But to know that four young men, promising, strong young men who have so much ahead of them, a really, really heartfelt, deepest sympathy to the family members, the parents. the mother lost two of her sons one time. Lord Jesus, it can't, that cannot be. I don't know how she's pulling through, but I trust somehow family members will help to keep her as strong as possible, you know, and just keep her going. And to all the other families and friends of these young men and young lady, deepest sympathy from the entire Styles family. Words can't express the sorrow that we are sharing with you for these lives lost so soon, too soon, really, really gone too soon. And I hope that their memories will live on with you guys, and may their souls rest in peace. So sorry, Marvin, and all the others who are going through a rough time. Really, really sorry for those loss, yeah? And Michelle as well, who's texting in. Such an unfortunate situation. I just have a word of caution to our friends out there. You know, there's a song, I think it's by Megan Rainor. And what's the song? We're not promised tomorrow, so I'm going to love you like I'm going to lose you. I think it's John Legend? I think it's John Legend and Megan Rainor. You'll find that song coming later, Cassidy. And it says, I'm going to love you like I'm going to lose you because we're not promised tomorrow. And I really, really urging the families out there, every day you wake up, appreciate each other so much as if it's the last day, because we just never know. We just never know. Love your family members. Love your husband, wives. Love your wives, husband. Love your children. You know, bless them up. Send them off. And just pray God's guidance for them to come back home. All right? Sometimes some family members live so bad. They don't talk to one another. Yeah? Them cuss out everybody. Them one another every day. Let's love each other and treat each other as if it's the last day. Because really and truly, the next day is just not promised. We don't even know what will happen this minute, next minute. But let us ensure that we do the best we can to embrace and to really genuinely love each other as Christ loved us. And also to ensure that we love other people as and treat them how we really want to be treated. Yeah? Donald, good to see you on with us tonight. I trust you're okay, my friend. A blessed Friday evening, he says, to Real Talk and your crew. Rest in peace to those Portlanders. But we have to use stuff like these to teach us to be patient and take life seriously. It's a beauty to be alive. Indeed, indeed. And people, they're really going somewhere. As a matter of fact, when we get back, I will tell you that one, because it's about now 9:33. The time is brought to us by BJ Printing Services, and Real Talk is sponsored by Native, oh Lord, let me get that straight. Native Audio. Native Equipment, Stage and Lighting. I say go audio lighting. I soon tell you all right when I come back. Here we soon come back.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Planning a party, club night out, stage show, a gospel concert, or even a business sales event? Let Styles FM be a part of your promoting tool. Take advantage of our low-priced promotion packages with commercials, interviews, giveaways, reviews, and much more. We have special offers when you mix and match and bundle your options. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Styles FM, for the most effective way to exploit your marketing dollar. For the best quality in sound. reinforcement and backlining, native audio. We have professional engineers with over 20 years of experience. So call us and we'll take care of your parties, wedding receptions, barbecues, conferences, and small stage shows. Crystal clear sound, native audio. Our prices are the best. Call us at 871-5212. That's 871-5212. Native audio. We make your events audible. Audible. Audible.
Y'all, this is Jati the Reggae Ambassador. Join me alongside Jati Jr. right here on Styles FM each and every Saturday from 1 to 5 p.m. for the Reggae Ambassador Entertainment Show. I'm going to take you on a musical ride in a yard style. Coming up, ska, rock steady, and oh yeah, we'll rock you from old to new. Roots, culture, and in a dancehall style, lily, lily, lee. And remember, each and every Saturday from 1 to 5 p.m. for the Reggae Ambassador Entertainment Show. Check it out. Right here on Styles FM. Yes.
Guess what? Styles FM has a new business number for you to call, text, and now WhatsApp. 518-2399. To advertise your business and events, call, text, or WhatsApp us on
518-2399. 518-2399.
Don't forget, 518-2399.
Native Audio Stage and Lighting, now offering stage, lighting, and truss systems for your small and medium-sized events. Whether it's a stage show, concert, drama play, wedding, street party, or club setting, you name it, we'll bring it to life. Call us at 871-5212 or 844-6531. Native Audio Stage and Lighting, a sponsor of In the Know of the Law with Sergeant Adele Rose Green and also Real Talk with Lady Cleo and Daddy Rude.
Welcome back to Real Talk, and of course you're tuned to Lady Cleo going solo tonight, and of course Cassidy, our engineer, will be keeping my company, and of course we'll be having some discussions as we go through. We go from now until 12 o'clock, so if you're just joining us, welcome to Real Talk. You haven't missed a lot. However, let me just remind you of the sponsors of Real Talk. Native Entertainment. I'm going to beat my engineer. Stage Audio and Lighting. That's NESAL. N-E-S-A-L is the acronym. Native Entertainment Stage Audio and Lighting. May not forget again. But you see, because we're so used to the other one, yeah, tongue tie up into that one. So we're going to have to unravel the tongue and get it tied up into the NESAL one. Okay? All right. And of course, before the break, I was sharing with you that, you know, when we're really, really going somewhere, and I've learned this not just from this incident, you know, but it's been said many times from family members and friends closest to me. When you're going somewhere really and truly, and you know it's a time-bound situation, please leave earlier. Yeah? Leave early. So I'm advising our friends, no matter where you're going and you have to reach there by a certain time, you know, if it's a plane you're going to catch or you have an appointment or something, try to get there, leave out early enough. And I know I have a friend who him not glitch when it come on to that. He has somewhere to go. He is leaving in time so he can drive moderately to go where he is going. He is not going to be rushing. So no matter how old people like me want come tell you for rush and whatever, he's not going to be rushing. So big up yourself, Dwight. Yeah? All right. Always safe driver on the road. And Gary too. I know Gary's like that too. Not speeding, go anywhere. Relaxed and going where they're going. All right. So let me just advise you to do that. Right? And another note that's really sore me. Seriously sore me up. Proper sorings. Is this young lady, this 27-year-old. I won't call her a baby because my daughter is 27 this year. So for her to be 27, she's a young girl, fresh. Ah, boy. And I tell the kids sometimes, you know, Cassidy, look, gravity and you're not a friend. Gravity and you are not a friend. The simplest thing is going to pull you to the ground. So when I see the kids up on some places and they, you know, recklessly hanging and doing some stuff, I say, listen to me. You can lose your balance. You can lose it and you can fall and you can hurt yourself. Don't be doing that. You know, don't be doing that. If it's something, you know, something you really, really have to do, don't be doing it, because you're putting yourself more at risk of being injured. And it's really sad. It's really sad that these persons who do this stunt dancing think that, you know, they're so good at it that nothing bad can go wrong. We have seen it happen before. You don't have to be on your head top. You're so cute. You don't have to be on your head top. Me now put my head on no ground. Can't see the thing. Nobody got jump and possibly I'll drop. You must be mad. Please, young people out there, young dancers, for God's sake. If you're really not something that you're practicing, and I don't mean the head tap part. You know, the dancers on Dancing Dynamite and so on, they'll do some stunts and some stuff, and some of them are really, you know, acrobatic and what they call it now, flexible and stuff, yeah? And some things you see on TV, don't go and go practice them, because trust me, and everybody can do everything, right? So please, young people, the entertainers, the dancers, male and female alike, take your little life a little bit more seriously, no do. I beg you no. Because it's really sad when we hear the young people who are passing away like this. Because this is just reckless. And that little video I saw, that just had me weak the whole time watching the news. It really, really just had me weak, because apparently the injury came from what you saw in the video, when she on the ground, it seemed like, you know, she had hurt herself right there. It's sad. It is really sad. We have a caller on the 453. We lost the caller. Caller, invite you to call right back, all right? Apparently, we're calling on an issue about the issue with the situations we're currently talking about. All right. Owen Nibs, pick up yourself. Artist from Salt Spring, Mobe. All right. Big ups to you. Artist, as in drawing artist or singing artist. Which one? All right, Street Side Soldier. Pick up yourself. It's the first time. Send us your name. Well, Owen is the name, right? We probably can add the name to that. I think he's overseas. I'm not sure there. All right, Kivoy, we see you locked in as well. Good to have you on board tonight. Let me shout out to all our friends in St. Mary. Let me go with St. Mary first. All our friends over there in St. Mary want to load you up tonight and big you up. Pick up yourselves and, of course, keep it locked. Bright Yai, I need your company tonight. Yes, trust Bright Yai wherever he is right now with his lovely chick somewhere. Yeah, he'll be calling us later on and sharing in the program. We also want to shout out to our friends in St. Thomas, all our friends in St. Thomas who always keep it locked. And if you have not called in for a long while and you're living in St. Thomas, tonight is the night to call or to text me. Okay? And big ups, of course, to Mommy, Auntie Janet, or Auntie, as some people call her. Yes, big ups to you, Mommy and Daddy up there in Whitehall, St. Thomas, and Uncle Barry and Brother Nell. Pick up yourself and the rest of the family, all right? And all the peeps from Whitehall and all boat in St. Thomas who lock in all the time. Anika in Seaforth, School Lane. Pick up yourself, cuz, all right? And, of course, we go now to our friends in Portland. Right here at Yard, all our Portland Massive and crew. All our uno from all over Portland. Big you up, Black Rock, Black Hill, Art Hill, Rio Grande Valley, all our unos, Port Antonio, Prospect, Anchovy, everywhere in Portland. We big you up tonight. Long road. I'm going to start calling you. No, Cassie did not help me out. Yeah, long bay. Mansion Neil. All boat. Karen in Monique. So we go to St. Anne. Our friend Karen, one of our avid listeners too. Pick up yourself, girlfriend. Yeah, and thanks for keeping it locked tonight to Styles and to Real Talk. So all our friends in St. Anne, the Garden Parish, large parish, if not the largest, I think it's probably the first or the second largest parish in JA. So big ups to all our friends who are able to lock in and see us or hear us in St. Anne. And of course, all our other friends across Jamaica who are watching via the World Wide Web, we say big ups to you right now. All right? Yes. So remember, the phone lines are open and we're going through the Vox Pop. You can feel free to call in and to share or to send us the message. All right, the local number again is 876-453-1444. And the overseas number is 954-338-7973. Loud ups to Vivian up there in Atlanta, Georgia. And of course to Tashauna, Gabriel, and Ethan. And Mrs. J, yeah, up there in what, Virginia, is it? Yes, big ups to us too. All right, so Cassidy, I'm so cold. It's cold inside here, I know. And of course, I urge all the peeps who are cold the last couple of nights and who are still cold tonight, go get a blanket. Blankets are sold in the stores. And if you don't have a live blanket, probably this year is the year to get yourself a live blanket. And if you've gotten a live blanket since the start of the year, now is the time to text me and say, Cleo, I am live and living warm. All right? And if you had a blanket from years before, no, all the better too. Yes, because the older the blanket, it should be able to keep you even warmer. Because it knows all your crevices and corners, yes, to keep you warm. All right. And remember, of course, the show is rated A for adults only. So all the children should be asleep. And all the adults should be locked in to the show. All right. Big ups to the crew up there in Sherwood Forest. The staff of the primary school, Sherwood Forest Primary and Infant. Big ups to all the hardworking staff members who go above and beyond the call of duty to ensure that the children learn, because we believe that every child must learn and every child can. And of course, together, the teachers, their work as assiduously as they can to ensure that they learn. Teachers going home all after 6-7 o'clock, seriously, because of the dedication and devotion. So big ups to the Sherwood Forest Primary and Infant School hardworking staff members, and of course, hardworking ancillary staff as well. All right, so tonight, Cassidy, we have our Vox Pop. Good night, Sonia. Good to see you on board, my darling. So we have, and I hope they're texting that Karen has a live blanket. Let me see what Karen is going to be saying to us before we go to that Vox Pop. I trust you're going to be telling me that you have a live blanket, Karen. Whether you got one since the year started or you had one before the year. She's taking long for type, though. All right. So let's see what our Vox Pop is. We come right back to those text messages in a moment. And I'm looking forward to see what Donald has to say tonight. And Bright, yeah. Yeah. So all the taxi drivers rolling by and rolling to and fro, carrying the people them safely home, not speeding, Not overtaking around a corner where you can't see. Yeah? The good up, real, real taxi drivers who drive sensibly on the road, big up on yourself right now. And all those traversing home and you're tuned to a radio somewhere, big up yourself. Enough blessings every time, all right? So here we go with our Vox Pop for tonight, guys. True friends versus true love. Why? True. True friends, Marvin versus true love. Which do you choose, though? You choose a true friend over true love? You know, let's hear more now. Your friend has been like a member of the family and is also single. So, ladies, you have a girlfriend. She is like your sister. She's like your mama's daughter. She's like your brother's sister. Yeah? And she's single. Brothers, you have a brethren who are your friend to the end, like Chucky. Right? Is that good or a bad thing? Cassidy? Is your friend to the end, like Chucky? Is that good or a bad thing? Good. Okay. Despite how bad Chucky is, the point is the friendship, okay? So, brothers, you have a brethren who you're in a role for years. You know, a brethren like that. Yeah? And he is close to the family. Everybody in the family pretty much know him. Right? And the gentleman's single. You hardly find that still. But anyway, I'm single. Anyway, dog a bun me out some say that, but it's true. You hardly find a man who is single. Would you grant a no objection? Would you grant a no objection for your partner and your friend to get into an intimate relationship if you were to pass away? Because we all know that, you know, death is inevitable. At some point in time, you know, we get old and we move along to another life, I guess. Is it okay for you to grant a no objection? In other words, you say, look here, man, if I were to pass on and gone, it is quite okay for my girlfriend, Celia, to be with my partner. It's fine. She's single. Why not? It's okay. I have no objections to that. Would you do that, ladies? Is that fine? Gentlemen, is it okay for your brethren? You know, after you pass on, Fee, yeah, get together now with moms, because really and truly, it's supposed to be that way because I'm a brethren and you look out for me, so I'm going to take care of my wife. Daddy Rude, I want to hear from you. Is it okay for when you pass on, sir, your close brethren who is single and might be single at the time, I don't know. Is it okay for him to get into an intimate relationship with your partner? Part two. People often say an ex is an ex, as if all things have been severed. Everything cut off. Look at a man. It's an ex that. So guess what? Me not have nothing to do with no ex. So if you want God to be with my ex, it's your business. Me all right with that. Me good with that. People often say an ex is an ex, as if all things have been severed. So then, should it matter if your friend and your ex were to start seeing each other? Should it matter? Would it matter if your friend, ladies, your girlfriend, starts seeing your ex? Would it matter, gentlemen, if your brethren started to see your ex? What are some of the things that would cross your mind? Okay. Part three of the Vox Pop. Would you have an issue if your partner chooses your friend as the person he or she confides in when there's an issue or when there are issues in the relationship? Why? Yes. And if no, why no? Look here, man. Every single day on a fight, every single day on a argue about something, some foolishness. And she's just so confused. She doesn't know what to do. She doesn't know who to talk to. But your brethren, Daddy Road, are the one who Karen got turned to. To talk to about the issues that she had got through with you. Bag of trouble. Problem. Is it okay for her to confide in your brethren? gentlemen, tell me now, Cassidy. It's okay for your brethren. The girl goes, look here now. I can't manage Cassidy, you know. Cassidy stress me out, you know. Every evening I come in and just want more and more. I'm tired. I'm just I can't manage and still stress me more and more. Should it be okay? Is it okay for her to talk to your friend? She's stressed out. You're under pressure. Cassidy face. Let me hear from you, Cassidy. Which one you go with first?
All right, so good night, people. So she want to go and talk to my friend about...
Yes, man. Oh, yes, Cesaro. Yes, man. She have problems with you. Issues. Only part issues. And she don't know what to do. She talk to you. It not work. She, you know, she could talk to your friend because he will listen and he understands you and he understands what she's talking about. Is it okay? People, I'm guessing his face and reluctance to answer it. No, okay, at all. I tell you, Cassidy make a big sigh.
All right, no, you see why I hesitated? Because I know exactly what my friend will say.
Really?
Yes.
What am I going to say? Go and go talk to your husband? I'm going to talk to Cassidy?
No.
What am I going to do?
Make sure I say, yeah, give it up more. I know exactly what my friend
I don't know
will
good friend that.
No, that's a good friend. That's a great friend.
Telling her to do what she can't manage to do.
No,
put her under more stress.
Let's make sure I say you're ready.
You hear that, people? You're my silent assassin. Make sure she give it up more. So the friend went tell the girl, say, look here, don't worry about that. Make him stress you. Just give it up more. And the more him want it, just the more you're going to give it up. So you're saying?
Exactly. You know, prefer me stress you down, go stress somebody else out the road.
Dad, put on the mic, silent one, put on the mic, you know, do. Mm-mm. You're too at the night here, you hear that? It better him stress her than him go stress somebody else on the road. That's a food for thought for true, you know. That's a food for thought for true. Real talk. So, we look at the first part now, people. And remember, the phone lines are open. I want to hear from you and you and you under the sheet. We're cool. Yes. So, true friends versus true love. Your friend is like your family member and the friend single. Is it okay? I got grant the okay for when you pass on for the friend and the your lover start deal with things. Ay, ay, ay. Now, people are going to say, boy, look, you know, it's when me pass on gone, I don't know nothing where I go on. So, it's neither here nor there to me. And many people will say that. Kevin in Tampa, Florida, pick up yourself. Yeah? So, some people will say, look, the fox say I'm a brethren, and the fox say I'm a girl. Me now go rest in my grave if you know, say, boy, they might even go on with that thing when I'm gone. Just imagine all of what me used to enjoy, and he might just take up now and just continue, no, sir. And some people might say, oh, no big deal. I'm gone. She has to move on with her life. Him needs to move on with female life too. So if I share the girl, it's okay. I would love to hear what the men think about this issue because I do believe that men and the women will have a completely different view. Prove me wrong if you must, but that's my view. I think the men and the women will have a whole different view, perspective on this. So, Kevin, what's your take on part one of the Vox Pop? All right, let's see what Karen was texting earlier. Let's see what Karen there is saying. Cleo, some man don't know how. Oh, if you keep woman warm, them turn them back. No, so something wrong with that one there. If the time call like how it is now, and a man does not know, some men don't know how to keep the woman warm, something is going wrong, ladies. What have you done or not done that you were supposed to do? You know, maybe are you a frown and a going one way the night before? I mean, you know, are you locked sharp, which you shouldn't do? And then him just come in and say, you know, I'm good enough. I want nothing from she right now because I'm good. We don't know what good mean because Cassidy say better stress she than stress somebody else around. So I don't know if when they turn the back is something they're saying. I don't know. But check what you did wrong. If you did anything wrong, and find out what really are going on, because when the time called, everybody wants to be kept warm. Everybody, all puss and dog, want to keep warm. All right? So, back to, have a caller? All right, so you're going to call back after the break. All right, we are going to our second break, guys. Oh, my goodness, it's 10 o'clock already. The time is brought to us by VJ Printing Services, and Real Talk is sponsored by Nissal, Native, Entertainment, Stage and Audio Lighting. We'll soon come back.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for a presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
The Big End Month Sale, DIB Block Factory and Hardware, all three locations, 7 Thompson Avenue, Buff Bay, Main Street, St. Margaret's Bay, 44 William Street, Port Antonio. Every end of month we got a big sale. Friday's the big tour bus for sale, standing all day. Get prizes and surprises, big discounts on all items. DIB Block Factory and Hardware, end of month sale, this weekend, this weekend.
Do you have or are you seeking a place to rent, seeking employment or have a job vacancy? Are you selling a car or having a garage sale? Then come see us. Let Styles do the advertising for you and you'll be on your way in no time. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Advertising Style. Advertise with Styles.
Here's your Prince just touched down in at the airport.
A royal day to everyone. It's Chungi with the voice of DJ Prince, your royalty of music selection, representing for my show, your show, Detour, every Saturday night from 8 p.m. to 12 midnight with mixed moves and attitudes. And ladies, don't forget the special Detour hour from 11 to 12 midnight. Styles FM, the world listens. You just gotta tune in.
Remember Styles FM on social media. View us on YouTube, Styles FM Radio. Follow us on Instagram at Styles FM. Like us on Twitter at Styles FM 961. Become a fan on Facebook, Styles FM 96.1.
Native Audio Stage and Lighting, now offering stage, lighting, and truss systems for your small and medium-sized events. Whether it's a stage show, concert, drama play, wedding, street party, or club setting, you name it, we'll bring it to life. Call us at 871-5212 or 844-6531. Native Audio Stage and Lighting, a sponsor of In the Know of the Law with Sergeant Delrose Green and also Real Talk with Lady Cleo and Daddy Rude.
The views expressed on this program are not necessarily the views of Native Broadcasting Network or Styles FM.
Welcome back to Real Talk. And of course, we go from now on, we continue until 12 o'clock. And this is your girl, Lady Cleo, going solo with my engineer, Cassidy, tonight. All right. So it's not solo fully, it's semi-solo. All right. So our Vox Pop, we were looking at our Vox Pop idea. And those who are calling prior to the break, we invite you to do so right about now, okay? All right. So the first part, again, your friend has been like a family member for a long time. That's how close you guys are. A part of the family, basically. And the friend is single. And we want to know if you would grant that okay for if you when you pass on, your friend and your lover, who you love so dearly, your treasure are like, I tell you, boy, you don't want to even fly pitch panar. All right? And the man that you treasure and love so much, is it okay for your girlfriend and him to get it on? Is it okay? Why shouldn't it be okay? Or why should they get it on? Did they have eyes on each other long time? Was she eyesing my man long time? Eh? Why ask me pass another rest on my grave? Good. Eh? Add it to them. Is it okay? Is there an issue with that for you? If so, do share. 876-453-1444. And if it's not a big deal at all, not a problem, please do share likewise. Overseas number 954-338-7973. I'd love to hear Dan Dan's take on the issue too. Yeah. I'd love to hear the take on that. Personally, the thought of being alive and the thought of them hooking up, kind of one way, you know. But as I said, you pass on, you know, you don't know what I'm going on. And how dare you dictate? Is it okay to dictate, you know, about somebody else's life after you pass on gone? Or prior to, you're going to dictate, so listen to me now. When me pass, you try your best, don't even look at my man, you know. No, I don't know. Good night, welcome to Real Talk. Dan Dan.
Be careful what to wish for, you know.
No, I'm not wishing that at all. I'm just saying the inevitable is. And when the inevitable comes, are you going to stop to think before it happens or what? What's your take on the issue, though? Is it okay for your girlfriend and your, you know, your bosom big friend to hook up after, you know, you are no more? Huh?
All right. Listen up. You know, I have ex-girlfriend. You know.
You don't?
No.
You have ex-relationships?
I have no exes.
Okay.
So, once a girlfriend, you're always a girlfriend.
How are you, sir, man?
I don't, you know, break relationship like that. So they come in your life for a reason.
Okay. Well, sometimes for, but.
Yeah, well, if they got to that status.
Yes.
If they got to that status, it's for a reason, you know.
But you're not a person who are no longer engaged sexually. You would say you were before and now you're not. Then it's no longer your person now, is it?
Well, me not really have, you see, I'm not in them ownership thing there, you know. So,
is it ownership though?
Eh?
Is it ownership? Because you're no longer talking to this girl on a sexual intimate or an intimate level then. You're no longer communicating like that. Is it okay for her and the guy to get along, get on, when you rest?
But what I say is, read the question again. The part two question again.
Part two, I'm going to read our part one.
What was part two again?
Part two. People often say an ex is an ex, as if all things have been severed. But for Dandan, it's not, by the way. Should it matter if your friend and your ex were to start seeing each other romantically? Now we know. What are some things that will go through your mind or across your mind? So you're on the girl, no longer sexually involved. And she start date your friend and they're having a blast of a time. You okay with that?
That is down to her. That is up to her. That's up to she.
I never ask you that, Dan Dan.
Nah, but look here. Nah, man. Listen,
you're okay. Listen. You're comfortable with that, Dan Dan?
Like me say, me not have the ownership like that.
So when the virgin come back and say, I tell you, man, Susie is just a gem of a girl. You don't have a feel no way, Dan Dan?
No, first of all, me not have no virgin who operate the way it
is. Hold on, you just say nothing wrong with it, but all of a sudden, you don't have no virgin who operate. Me not understand. Come operate how?
No, who would I know say me and Susie there are
did there
something going on and then moving to Susie. No.
So what if he finds Susie attractive? Just as your eye them did catch Susie. Or Susie did catch your eyes. Susie is an attractive, very lovely lady.
Like me say, Cleo, me not gonna make that bother me.
So you're not going to cross your mind. Nothing ever cross. Dan Dan, top tell lie, man. Nothing ever cross your mind, Dan Dan.
That is their choice. No, listen to me now, Claire. That is their choice. No, listen to me now. If my virgin pass,
yes.
I'm gone.
Mm-hmm.
See? And him girl need comforting. never comfort her.
Me know.
You know.
Me know, Dan Dan. Me know.
I mean, in pass. Likewise, if me pass, I mean, it would not, you know, if there's life after that, we never had no qualms that even you that.
Okay, fair enough. So my take now is, because I'm interested in your part too. Let me tell you now. So if it's a case, you see, where you and Susie did have it going on real mad, real hot.
Yeah.
And sometimes you're in your bed at home now all alone. Sometimes you sit back and you reminisce. And you say, geez, I'm P-Star. Yo, I miss Susie no star. And you remember now, say, Susie, gone with Cassidy. That not gonna affect you, my youth? What you tell me, say?
No, man. If not Susie, have a hat like that. No, man. She's not gonna know nothing about Cassidy. Now going to a number of
But guess what? You and Susie now go on pan the ends again, you know, man.
Mm.
Something does not go on for you no more. Susie kind of probably outgrow you, you know. And
Cleo,
Susie does wit.
Look on it. Look on it this way. Everybody, apart from me, I have several exes.
Yeah.
No, those exes would have moved on to have, in my likelihood, great relationships, great sexual encounters, whatever. Then, you know, whether you know that person who them having that great time with,
yes,
or not, but they know them or not, it really ought not to matter. The thing is, what should matter is that you're happy for your ex.
Happy for your ex? What you say?
Yeah.
What you say? I owe you so righteous tonight.
No, hold on.
Don't get me wrong. Yes.
Hold on. Let us say in your lifetime you've had five exes. You wouldn't want none of the five of them to have it at like where, you know, you used to have with somebody else. You wouldn't.
I'm not saying yes to that so easy. I'm not going to say yes readily to that. I'm not saying yes readily to that.
No,
hold on, man. Hold on. Don't get me wrong, you know. I'm not saying I wouldn't wish for the ex happiness, you know. And I don't wish them all the best.
You just don't want to happen with somebody who you know.
Well, precisely. Oh, I'm a friend. No, sir. No, with my friend like that. We can't manage that one. It's a nice.
No, that's so
you
selfish.
Can't stay there, go and show up because the caller say you now come straight. The texter say you now come down and now come straight. Look here. If it is that they're happy with somebody you don't know, it's a different feeling from somebody who is your friend. And it worse for men than it even is for women, I think. Trust me.
I know he's
with a lady. Yeah. Hold on, man. I know he's with a lady who, I know her, yeah, I see her around the place and everything good. Yeah, man, him and her go on, no problem. Good, all good. Wish them all the best, all the happiness. But if you know now, say my good up sister with me and her, relate about enough things long and hard and... Boy, sometimes I say, boy, you know, so things don't go well still. I mean, I don't know what else to do and blah, blah, blah. And now, all of a sudden, now, and him and she know, sir, all kind of something going through my little brain from them time there. Then wait, to the time when she tell me so and so and so. She do want me to mash up so she can get in with him. All kinds of thoughts going run through my brain when I see them together. Because me, I say, wait, now my friend, dad, how she reach there, sir? So me know how you know then I go see the girl nowhere. Have your head spin a certain way. Have your two heads a spin a certain way. And you're going to see her with your brethren. And now I feel no way, my youth.
All right. Let me ask that question.
Uh-huh.
Your ex, all right? Hook up with your with your good friend, your good girlfriend. See? And you know them hook up, but the relationship is rocky. All right. Would you be comforted by that?
Little bit.
Jesus, Father.
We never said no. We said little bit.
So in other words, you don't want your friend enjoy happiness like that.
And happiness that. A torture, you're torturing me.
No.
You're torturing me psychologically.
No, man. She hook up with your ex, you know, because, you know, 2 weeks ago when I said people have a need to be in a relationship, whether it's good or bad or whatever. So it's a situation. She just want to have it say she have a man.
No, sir. All right? No, my friend. No go there, sir. Uh-uh.
No go there, sir.
No go there, sir. Too many things will be on my head.
The bottom line.
It's going to affect our friendship, number one. It's going to affect our friendship. Trust me. It is going to affect our friendship.
Well, okay. So which is more important? Your friendship with her or her intimacy that she longs for? Which is more important?
To who? To me or she?
No, she, her intimacy with your ex, which is more important to you?
What's more important to me is my sanity. And the fact that she and my ex get in, not going to help me to maintain that so well, because I'm going to be thinking, how did she get there? How did we get How did we get there? I mean, I'm just going to be thinking that deception is in there all along from both of them. I'm going to think that she eyeing him long time, even when we were together. I'm going to think that she was carrying news all along. She had tell lie upon me all along. I'm going to think all sorts of things. And the friendship that we once had will just not be the same. That's just straight up how it is, real talk.
Have you, all right, you know, there have been situations where, all right, a couple, right?
Hey.
And let's say you're the wife, you're sick, you're in the hospital, and you're not get better.
Uh-huh.
And you know, your husband come visit you, and your best friend come visit you. Everybody come visit you, I think. All right. And because of the situation, friends get closer. Your husband,
mm-hmm,
and your best friend,
uh-uh,
female friend. All right.
It's painful when you say that together, though. It's very painful.
Get close. No. Yeah. Get closer and closer to the point where them check for each other like that. Intimacy or grand. Would you object to that? Knowing that you're upon your deathbed and you don't know.
Yes, me objecting. Eh? That's like them committing homicide.
So if you know, if you suspect
that women make me go faster. Why don't one kill me up before time?
Okay, why you come make them think out of your head?
No, sir, it's out of my head. Me not like it's out of my head. When I see them coming in here together, coming to look for me and feeding me and tidying me and whatever, and knowing so when them gone off to them yard, or when them left hospital and gone, me one up then I call hospital, and a white sheet, and pan white sheet, and a drip.
But,
and all me can think about is how him and she sorting out in a nice warm bed.
Yeah,
no, my love.
But,
can't work.
But remember, you are getting your warmth from him just the same now.
I mean, get no warmth me in a hospital under drip saline. What happened to you? No, okay. Dandan, it can't work. Can't work, Dandan. Can't work.
So you'd rather suffer in loneliness just like you, right?
I'll go find somebody else if that be the case. When we gone, I'll find somebody else.
Somebody else, but just not your friend.
Not my friend, no.
Wow.
Real talk.
Okay. I hear you.
Thank you, Dandan.
Well,
yes.
In closing.
Yes, sir.
If I'm the friend.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, if I'm the friend and my friend wife or needs that comfort, you know, why should I withdraw that from her? Why should I withhold that from her?
Knowing you, Dandan, I know that's quite fine with you. Me know.
Yeah, but the situation. What's wrong with that?
But you're still afraid to answer me and tell me how you're gonna feel when she gone to the brethren. But you will comfort her. You will comfort the friend, girl. But you not talk how you feel when she gone to your friend.
Nah, man. It's choices. You make your choices. So
I know, right?
Go out with the choices.
I know, Dan. I know, Dan.
You know. Edwin, I mean, you people, well.
Yes, Dan, and keep it locked and come to the other one afterward, the other part after this. Let's see what Sadie's saying. Thanks, Dan. Always depending on Dan there. Can depend on him to call in. Cleo Wagwan, I'm here, sweetie. Cleo, is me alone in my bed. I'm warm sometime. Sometimes you think you have life blanket and it's a dead one. The man dead, so no problem. It's the best man for have, especially if you have money and honey. Deliver me, Jesus. Oh, gosh. Sometimes you're in your bed and you think you have a life blanket. It's a dead one. Oh, boy. Sidious says, Lady Cleo, better my best friend take him more than my enemy. Me dead and gone, don't know a thing anyway. Food for thought too. But when me gone and him want get it on, me won't know. But not while me alive. Me not gonna figure about that part. Me not lie. Miss Brown, hey Miss B, how you doing, girlfriend? Long time. Good night, Cleo. That can't work for me. Not my friend dead left lover. Oi. So, Miss B said, look here, man, our friend, dead left, gone left this man. Yeah. Me no want him. Mm-mm. That's what Miss B is saying. Me no have no use for that one. Okay? Dan now come straight. All right. Let's see what Kevin says. Kevin says, Dan not speaking honestly. Why, Dan them have your ticket tonight, you know. Let's see what Michelle Wilton is saying first. Even though he's asking those questions, it definitely would affect him. I know, right? No matter who you are, strong, no matter how strong you think you are, it definitely would affect the individual seeing their loved one hooked up with their friends. Let me know to you. Let's see what Michelle in Snow Hill is saying. You will right beside the man and still feel alone. You know, it's true though. It happens. You'll be right beside him and feel alone, or right beside her and feel alone too. That's sad though. If a caller on the 954, looks like Dan again. Hey, Dan.
Cleo.
Yes.
Me in the hospital, a back of an arm to stay alive. And when my best friend and my wife come in and I notice my twinkle eyes, so that's not bother me, and I am more concerned about recovering. Who that's not bother me?
Look here, as concerned as you are,
as
concerned as you are about recovering. Look here, the fact that they are eating it all when you're not there, you can't see what you know what going to bother you. I mean, no business. Who you want to say?
Nah, man, no.
It's like a butter Daddy Rude. It's like a butter Cassidy. It's like a butter you. So, I don't know, you don't even know it yet. And it going bother me. What's that going bother me?
Nah, bother me. That matter me. Me, I have more concern about my recovery. That is what's important there, sir.
So, wait there. You thinking about your recovery will make you recover? No.
Of course.
No, it can't.
But, If that's not gonna bother you, that's gonna affect your recovery.
That is the point. So when me know it must affect me, me can't help but think about it.
Then Cleo, which is more important to you? You want to recover? I want going to remit. Which is more important?
Let me ask you a question. Have you ever had things on your mind where you try to take off and it now come off? Talk the truth.
No.
Where you come from again? Which planet?
Hey, look. Jaja give us life, and Jaja give us life abundantly.
I agree. Live I know all of that.
You can't.
Dan.
Come on.
I know all of that.
Life is for living.
I know all of that. Humanly speaking, remember, say it's not an ordinary man, shoot it, you know. He's your best friend, your close friend. Come on, man. Come on,
right,
man.
Clear.
In a hospital bed, and you're dying. And you have to say that now across your mind.
All right.
You have to go recover.
Probably why I can talk this way.
Mm-hmm.
You see, from about 13, 14.
Yes.
you need to do some serious meditation upon life.
Yes.
All right? Because you know, you're 13, 14, and you're at a puberty stage, and you go through some things where, you know, probably not things now work out, and, you know, certain things. So to conquer some of them things, you
see,
me just go off by myself, but you know, I'm not apple tree and stuff. Meditate my life.
My apple tree?
See? Apple tree. Because you can eat apple.
You eat apple.
Apple are my favorite fruit.
All right.
Yeah. See? So look here now.
Yes.
When you are able to enter into a state of meditation and what you want out of life, whether it is relations or whatever.
Yes.
You are able to overcome some of these things that no physical can't overcome.
Well, I know what you're saying to an extent, because it's mind over matter. Many things in life is really mind over matter, right?
Yeah.
But the reality is, though, for many people, and of course, as somebody said, you're one in a million. For many people, the mind is a heck of a thing sometimes. And now when you know, think about certain things.
You can train the mind.
Yes, because at 13, we weren't up in an upper tree meditating like you. It's going to be difficult at this point. You understand?
All right, okay. Yeah, because it's hard to teach old dogs new tricks,
exactly. So if all you can think about is, all that's coming back to your head is, yo, star, then really and truly, them eat it on, I'm never dead yet. No, I mean, I ask them, them eat it on. How long ago this thing got started with them? All these things are natural thoughts, man.
I believe there's too much of us in society. Too many of us are negatively wired.
It's not negative wiring. It's just natural, real talk experiences, my youth.
You see, no, you consider it to be natural. I would consider it to be unnatural.
And we would consider you to be abnormal too.
Well, I guess normal is
relative.
Majority.
It's quite relative.
Abnormal is with minority. So
yes.
Maybe in that sense.
Yes.
But the point is, meditation can take off some of them stress where you don't need to put yourself into.
So in the hospital bed, just lie down there and just meditate and just go and watch the drip. Just a drip tip.
I don't say meditate, but I'm not gonna meditate in the hospital bed. But I'm saying maybe I'm
is the best place to meditate
in my thought processes that. That not gonna bother me in the single leaf.
Why, then I'm yet to find out where you're really from, because I don't think it's from Earth. It's a very special place, though.
don't get me wrong, though. No. I have been hurt once or twice by
you have. You know what the meaning of that word is?
But then what?
You harden yourself because of it.
No, I realize it. Is me allow myself to be hurt.
Oh.
Me never have to be hurt.
Real talk. All right, cool. Sir. Big up yourself, Dan. I like Dan's view, though, about not having any exes. He says he doesn't have any exes. Yeah, they're all friends still, okay? All right, Mama Winsome. Hey, Mama Winsome, how you doing? Good night, my goddaughter and all the Styles family. My condolences to all the families who have lost their loved ones. Indeed, rest in peace, Mama Winsome. All right, thank you, Mama Winsome. I'm sure they're hearing. Damien in Florida. Pick up yourself, Damien. How you doing? Upfulness, McLeo. My philosophy is no one owns anyone. People are free to do whatever they wish. While you're still alive in front of your yai, I don't know. All right. Not playing that game, Karen in Monique says. Me, I got dead before time. I tell you, sister, it's going to only just plunge you deeper. Yeah? Miss Brown says that I got kill him quicker than mean. Dan don't love his wife. That means Dan don't love his wife. He might very well soon come back to defend his argument. Wilton says, well, Dan, you are one in a million. Did we get the first part of that of Wilton just now? The first message, did we? Yes, all right. So Wilton not played a game the either. Wilton not depend that. Michelle in Snow Hill says, that would be haunting me. Like when Smitty said, dope it. Bum me. Knowing my man and with my best friend. That would definitely be haunting for true. Worse, you're in a hospital, as the scenario he presented, you're in a hospital bed. Why? You start see all kind of something. Your mind start imagining all kind of something. You just start feel all kind of something. They send you off quicker, don't it? Big and serious. Well, Damien in Florida, big up Dandan. I support your reasoning, brother. Progressive through progress. Progressive with my husband. Go progress with somebody else, man. With my best, or with my best friend. Go progress with somebody else. Seriously. That's not the only means of progress right there. That means you were icing my guy a long time, girl. Huh. This one, 573. 573, send your number so we can add the number, please. Hi to you, too. All right. And, of course, it's now 10:30, guys. When we come back, we share more of the Vox Pop with you. And please do indulge and share the rest of it in the rest of it with us. The time is now 10:30. It's brought to us by VJ Printing Services. And Real Talk is sponsored by Nessal, Native Entertainment Stage, Audio, and Lighting. Stick and stay. We soon come back.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Good day, driver. You notice that you're parking in a no parking zone. You know, so you can get a ticket for this, sir.
Really, officer? But just want to pick up some hardware supplies, you know. Do me a beg, you give me a blind, huh?
So if you need hardware supplies, why you don't go to Ramtula Supercenter and Hardware?
Ramtula Supercenter and Hardware, 34 Folly Road, Port Antonio, Portland. We stock a wide range of products at the best prices in town. At Ramtula's Hardware, experience the three C's: comfort, competitive prices, and convenience. Ramtula Supercenter and Hardware opens 8 a.m. to midnight, 7 days per week. Call 715-5132. Email ramtulasupercenter@gmail.com. Remember, we have the best prices in town.
Your sadness will never be the same again. 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. on Styles FM. Get the showdown. Social commentary. Tune
no,
what tune?
No ice cream sound.
Good morning, teacher. Love time, teacher.
E-Edge, your love with love song. All happening.
Love songs are
between 9 a.m. and 1 p.m. on the People Station, Styles FM, 96.1, 96.5, 96.7, only the smooth sailing, with Colin Anthony, shock up to the fame.
One of things I've been done, one of things I've been done, when my chances have come.
For the best quality in sound reinforcement and backlining, Native Audio. We have professional engineers with over 20 years of experience. So call us and we'll take care of your parties, wedding receptions, barbecues, conferences, and small stage shows. Crystal clear sound, Native Audio. Our prices are the best. Call us at 871-5212. That's 871-5212. Native Audio. We make your events audible.
Planning a party?
club night out, stage show, a gospel concert, or even a business sales event, let Styles FM be a part of your promoting tool. Take advantage of our low-priced promotion packages with commercials, interviews, giveaways, reviews, and much more. We have special offers when you mix and match and bundle your options. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Styles FM for the most effective way to exploit your marketing dollar.
Native Audio Stage and Lighting, now offering stage, lighting, and truss systems for your small and medium-sized events. Whether it's a stage show, concert, drama play, wedding, street party, or club setting, you name it, we'll bring it to life. Call us at 871-5212 or 844-6531. Native Audio Stage and Lighting, a sponsor of In the Know of the Law with Sergeant Adele Rose Green and also Real Talk with Lady Cleo and Daddy Rude.
The views expressed on this program are not necessarily the views of Native Broadcasting Network or Styles FM.
Welcome back to the show, guys. Good to have you back with us. If you're just joining us, welcome, welcome, welcome to this episode of Real Talk. Lady Cleo is on tonight with Cassidy. All right, so we're looking at the Vox Pop, and just after we repeat the Vox Pop for you, we're going to be sharing with you the views out there. Yeah, Real Talk viewers. All right, so true friends versus true love. Your friend has been like a member of the family and is also single. Would you grant a no objection for your partner and your friend to get into an intimate relationship if you were to pass away? Explain. People often say an ex is an ex, as if all things have been severed. Should it matter if your friend and your ex were to start seeing each other? What are some of the things that would cross your mind? Oh boy. Would you have an issue, if your partner chooses your friend as the person he or she confides in when there are issues in the relationship? And of course, a part two, what are some of the things that would go through your mind if it is you discover that your ex and your good up friend, real good friend, your best friend, are now seeing each other? Well, for one, first up, a long time them a gwan, or a whole long no them a friend like that. Them did a gwan behind my back. Huh? Oh, come. All right, so here we go with the Vox Pop, and let's see what's happening out there from the people. What the views are.
Touchy subject. Big up on the self talk family. Ah, boy, you know what I say? That's something with no objection. Why, if you go say yes, you basically give them a go ahead to start it right now. Then probably start it and just kill off because it's nicer to them together. You know, so have a look on it that way there, because then they must wait for you for dead to start it, you know, and they might speed up the process. Cause who to tell, you know, who to tell? Cause then just maybe just use that as friendship and say, yeah, man, it's one of my friend like brother and thing and rare and something, you know, and just mash it up. Ah, X is an X, yes, but boy, more time when you see your friend or somebody who really close to you with that somebody they are cut up, you feel a weird. Because just imagine you used to get some serious loving from that somebody there. All of a sudden you're bridging and experience that loving there. You know? Whereas if it's a man who love chat, you come and say, you know, in the work. White people something. Might some love talk about the white people something, but yeah, white people something, you know. Next issue. Ah boy. Hey, when I touch some point in the night, I know now mash up my mid, you know. Would you have an issue if your partner chooses your friend as the person she confides in their issue? We don't have no choice. We don't have no choice. Majority of the time, are that person they go talk to, because they will talk to that person and say, yo, your friend, you know, you can talk to him, you know, or I talk to her and I your friend, you know. So we can't get a friend that. We don't try some of that. And if you try to push it, yeah, man, you're going to lose that friend, man.
Because you say a friend is like a close member of your family. That means you're really close. Somebody will know everything about you, like one of your cousins or somebody you really trust to make them that close to your family. And you go there and then go there with your people, I'm like, you're yeah, I get a kid, for real. She was the kid.
Listen to me. A friend is a friend in need and a friend indeed. Who can me have my friend? And who say me when they sleep with somebody? Regardless, I'm not in this life no more. My friend must respect my loyalty as my friend, whether I'm alive or dead. And who say my partner was my partner, and she know, cause if me went alive, would she wanna sleep with my partner? Cause if me dead, and she go and sleep with my man, and know it was my man. That mean to say she would have sleep with him whether me dead or me alive. So for me no agree with that, none at all. My friend not supposed to, whether I'm alive or I'm dead, my friend not supposed to have no thought of wanna sleeping with my man. That is a no-no for me. Me no know about nobody else. And whether my ex or not, my friend not supposed to want have. If my friend no know, say I'm my ex and get caught up with him is a different story. But if my friend know, say I'm my ex, my friend not supposed to want to sleep with my ex, because if my friend want to sleep with my ex, that mean my friend would have sleep with my man. And as some see it. Because if you is a loyal friend to me, there's no way, there's nobody that I have a relationship with or been in a relationship. As a friend to me, you're not supposed to want to be with that person. Because guess what? Even when the person become your ex, you and the person may still talk and communicate, even if we're not sleeping together. But no, my friend no want to go sleep with my ex. No, sir. That no look good. That no look right at all. And if me have one issue, my friend not supposed to be the person my partner go to with the issue with me have. With that not supposed to be, unless I confident say, okay, me want so and so, there's an issue and me want it, so and so for discuss. That's a different case, but you're not supposed to anything me and my partner have my run go to my friend for go discuss. You know, that I go look like say, okay, all of my business, I be my friend want for discuss it. That means to say something I go wrong right there, so for me, because if my man I go discuss everything, or my husband I go discuss everything with my friend, that means to say to me is that my friend or my husband or my man have something going for me. Me no know about nobody else. Me no support that, none at all. So that in my book, that is not logical in my vocabulary. Real talk.
Real talk, Chom, real talk. Look here. If we've never had a real vox pop tonight, I tell you why. The void, Chom, I tell you, say, yo, that vox pop is solid. I tell you, Chom, talk the things them as usual. Chom, no joke. On a very serious note, if it is that you're my friend, in a life, I ain't look for my husband. In a death, no look for him either. Real talk. Because if you don't respect me, respect my memory, we're dead and gone. My memory, we have no respect that. It's true, Chom. Real talk. Realest talk right there. So I'm not lying. I'm not joke. Yeah. Me give a blank. Wally pa blank, Chommy. Wally pa blank. In the studio. So, there you have it from peeps out there, the boy Ed Atop, with the last two parts of the Vox Pop. I could tell them Ed really Atop for true. Trust me. So part two, Dan and I talk about, oh, you want to be happy and you're in the hospital and you don't wanna be thinking about your ex. Your guy, your girl and whomever. You wanna be thinking about recovery, master. All when you dip on your last breath, the thought then going lick your left, right, and center. You could have deal. Me no care what that Dan want tell me say. Me no say. With all the pain I walk through my body on that bed with white sheet, me no say. Me I go start to think all kind of something on my head. All kind of thoughts going to start flying through my brain. Cassidy, on a serious note, Cassidy. Talk truth. Daddy Rudy is not here, so don't be afraid. Talk truth. This is the night you can talk the truth because Rudy not there. Right? For you to look. All right. So seriously now, you and your girl break up. And you see your brethren when you and him close away, like brothers. Yeah? With the chick. Talk it truth. He not gonna kill you. Mr. Talk Truth, you know? Mr. Talk Truth.
You know, them say when I kill them, make you stronger, right?
Yeah, you know. You sound like rude. But when I kill them, make you stronger. Massa?
No, but it's the truth.
It's gonna make you stronger to do what? Die faster?
No.
If it is, no. That's the scenario about being in the hospital. And you see them come look for you and, you know, take care of you. And you, know, you say, wait, didn't you cannot chummy do? What am I move so? Am I move one way? You know? You tell me it's going to be okay. Eh? It's going to be... Yes, rude, yes. You mean say, okay. We've seen them together, knowing say, the possibility is, yo, they might touch a long time in a star. Yo, she deceived me. Yo, that you, then I'm a brethren. What kind of deception this? You know, I feel now you tell me the truth.
Yeah, but you don't know all them together. He might bring her come at the hospital, come look for me, bring her back home and go in yard.
Really?
Yeah.
Really? You know what? Go and go sleep. Go and back to sleep. You hear? Go and back to sleep. Me see what the one rude him, I text me, say no, because me want to know what kind of have love for him, say have love for the living. You're not wishing well for the living. What's wrong with you? What is the living ain't wishing well for me who is sick? They're wishing me to go faster, according to the boy. You're a bad man life. What kind of bad man life? Those two are wicked to see me there, suffering, and come before me, come present themselves. No. True, you're soon dead. Look at you're wicked, no. You're the wicked one. On a very serious note, no. Whether I'm sick or not, whether the person's sick or not, nobody can feel good to know that their best friend is now with somebody they had such a great time with. Things were good. When it was good, it was good. And when that dancing was fun, it was really good dancing, yeah? And now you're telling me, say, your best friend, they enjoy all them sweetness there, them nice times there, and you must just sit back, relax, pan your white sheet, and not feel no way? Oh, no. Oh, no, no, no. And me know say the one rule you feel bad, you know. People, me not ask. Me know say he couldn't manage it. So I can go and show up tonight. He could have never managed, you know, say. His best friend gone touching meat. You want the best for me? I want the best for you, but you go find the best from somebody else, not my friend. Let's see what Sadie is saying there. Oh my, in your socket, call all of a sudden because that rude text in. Seriously, you know? All the way my sense does make in you get colder, I swear it. Me know wife and mate that live real good, so you can all stay there and make head at up. That a go on, but what Sadie? Earl, yeah, you might have wives and mates that live good. You might have that, and you do have that, Sadie. I'm not saying no. But, boy, I don't know. I don't really see myself as sanction it. If it happened, it happened. But then I don't really want it to be a case where in front of me, them just decide for just to them thing, you know, like, all of a sudden, me just see them I move away, close. No, CD. No, me can't do it. Mm-mm. Winsome says, no sanky, no sing so. Do dan dan not talk the truth. But deep down in him heart, I bust out. Mama Winsome, I agree with you here, man. Where is Donald in all of this? Where is Donald? I want the best for that one, him, you know. That shine head one, I want the best for him, but him not going to get the best through my best friend. Let's see what he's saying there. He's texting in. I don't even know if I want to read the text, you know. I might just ban him tonight. We have a caller. And Dan Dan's name is coming up so much time that Dan Dan had to call back. I know he would. I knew he would. Good night, Dan Dan, again.
Hey, people must learn to be able to free your own mind.
You know,
I have a song for emancipate yourself.
You can't go and talk. You can't, your root
nobody,
can't go and talk.
No, well, I know, nobody but yourself can free your mind.
Hey.
Nobody. So is you for the term, you know, whether you want to live in a freedom, mental freedom,
or mental otherwise. Slavery.
Our mental slavery is up to you.
But Dan, on a very serious note, people will admit and tell you that even when they try to stop thinking about the two people them, it is going to happen. It's inevitable. And you can't control the inevitable.
All right. Just, let me tell you where it probably might be potentially bothersome. You see, if you and your wife break up, or you and your girlfriend break up.
Yes.
See? And you're left with no one, all right? Because probably you are a one burner. All right?
Mm-hmm.
I have no one to fall back on. See? And then every time it's like your girlfriend now, like your ex girlfriend or ex wife now, like I take a revenge thing for you.
Mm-hmm.
And pass by and like a show off, you know.
Mm-hmm.
That is another dimension, because no, she has show off for you. And you're not nobody for rap back band.
But Dan, for you who's so strong and everything, that shouldn't bother you, my youth. It's mind over matter.
No.
Get yourself a prettier girl.
But hold on, we come to the reality now.
Hey,
we're coming to reality.
You just wake up. All right, go on talk.
No, because you would have known what, you know, probably what the reason is behind it. It's probably a sure thing as a means to get back at you.
But no. No, Dan, let us discuss now, because we can reason this talk through now. Listen to me now.
Yes.
My take is...
Let's discuss what's real. Yes.
Hold on. My take is, the fact that you know so she a show off, for me, not going to hurt me so hot. Me not lie. Because me know she a show off, the youth a show off for me. So it not going to hurt me that bad.
There you go. Okay.
But you see, when me don't know...
That is so true.
Aye, but you see, when him get in with her now, I mean, I know what really good. I'm going to sit them together. It's going to kill me fast. I'm not lie to you.
No, man.
So to each his own. To each his own.
I agree that each own is each own. I agree that, look here, me not knocking anyone.
Because
if them don't feel them can't get past this. I'm not knocking anyone for that. You know?
Right.
You know, because you know we are a product of what we learn.
Right. And our socialization, right?
Yeah, exactly. Right. I'm not going to answer that.
Why, Dan? You know? You're good, though. You're good.
Well,
because despite the other spin you just put on it, either way kills me faster. Just seeing them getting closer and closer going to kill me. Because my mind going all over the place. My mind going to wander all over the place. And I have a very strong imagination. It's when that start put to work, a judgment.
I've been in a situation where I deal with a girl. And me realize that she mentally left me already, like what Daddy would have said.
Mm.
She mentally left me already and do it somebody else. See? But me don't make that bother me. I was hurt that we break up. But not that she got go with somebody else. No, that never hurt me. I was hurt of the relationship that I was losing with her. Not what she was getting with somebody else.
But even that clear CM where my youth.
What you were losing
with her, not clear CM where as if
to,
what you lost, what she do getting with somebody else.
You have to be able to compartmentalize. All right.
So
what it is. You are distraught by losing her. You're not distraught by who she's gaining.
But everybody distraught by different levels, mind you, because some people will tell you, say, look.
All right, well, me assure you with me, you know.
And you see, men are from Mars. Men are from Mars, women are from Venus, right?
Because me check for you like that.
And me check for him like that. So no, me not really, me think about when me losing, yes. But then me also think about, say, While me did I get this, should I get it too? Yeah, I mean, never nah, know. No, sir.
Well,
go to your mind. Me not lie.
Not my mind.
All right, sir. All right, well, later. Apple meditated. Yes. Dan's apple meditated mine. Well sorted out with apple juice. All right. The one rude him saying about, if I'm me I roll out to the angels. New meds. Make him go on with me old wife. Sex on the clouds, me thing there. This madman. Oh, Lord, goodness. Roll out with the angels, no? The angels might box you back to earth somewhere. When I roll out with angels. The devil rolling out with the angels. What a sight. Oh, boy. Let's see what part three to the Vox Pop says. So, Cassidy, what will be going through your mind? You didn't tell me. I want to know what will be going through your mind if you when you see them together. Your ex and your best friend, your good up friend, your real, real brethren, like a brother from another mother. What would be going through your head? You know, tell me all now. Across your mind. Them the long time, don't. Hear this now, people.
All right, to really think of it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, some would actually smile.
Mm-hmm. Because from Dandan, weird camp.
Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, I know, so basically, I mean, I have nothing to worry about.
Mm.
Yeah, I mean, I say, well, after 3 inches, me good.
So, you're not going to remember what you're losing?
No. After 3 inches, everything good.
Oh, yes, so, man.
You're not have nothing to worry about after that.
Are you sure? Look here, now, man. Cassidy, too hot tonight, you know.
If you know your friend like that, you're only going to say, yeah, after 3 inches, everything good.
Oh, Jesus. What else cross your mind, Cassidy? Apart from telling yourself so you're good, convincing yourself so you're all right. You're still not going to stop and say, well, I'm good enough, but I wonder how long them did I go on for. You're not going to cross your mind like, so when until you start going with that thing? Sure. I'm not miss nothing because that never all that. All right, sure. She losing out right now because me no say she not get nothing there, sir. What's going to go through your mind? Something must go through your mind by you.
All right, not necessarily, no, because the two of y'all lose, basically.
Because she not have you?
Yeah.
Okay.
But she'll be losing more.
Why?
As she lose you, and you lose she.
Oh. But what if all she have is a better gain? You would know otherwise.
But as me say, after 3 inches, everything all
right. You know what?
Everything all right after that.
All right, sir. All right, sir. I hear you. Oh, boy. Let's see what part three to the Vox Pop says, guys. Would you have an issue if your partner chooses your friend as the person he or she confides in when there are issues in the relationship? I don't have more than one issue. Mega have a whole heap of problem with this one. We have a caller on the 954. Good night, caller. Welcome to Real Talk.
Good night, Cleo. Just tell me your topic. What's your topic?
Well, we're looking at true friends versus true love. So we really were talking about if your ex-man, your ex-husband, and your friend, your good girlfriend, start to go on with that thing. You got a problem with that? Should it matter? And what are some of the things that would go through your mind when you start to see this?
When you say ex, like how long you break up?
It no matter how long me love him or your ex, whether you just break off for last year or last month, or your ex.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Me listen, and to me it's a two-way.
Yes.
No, what I agree, but this is my piece. Because if me and him break up over a year and him and my best friend start talk, me move on somewhere around the corner with my other piece.
Yeah.
So, me not really, I don't really feel jealous of my friend because me don't have one already and me put my mind over here upon him already.
Right.
Right, and wish you good luck. What if her husband, my ex her husband, see her lifetime? Me go marry Sarah, everything and blah, blah, blah. But she's happy living it within them, get married and see her lifetime. She have her husband. Or if it's me, the lifetime, me find my husband, which is your ex.
Eh.
You understand? So if me I go push him away, then me I go lose my husband or my wife's lifetime.
Mm-hmm.
So it all depends how.
So if it's a new breakup, it worse than if it were a long time breakup. That's what you're saying. If you not just break off, if you're the guy just break up, it is worse than if you break up long time. That's what you're saying?
No, if we just break up and them start out, then me think something did that one.
Why?
No, me say if we just break up and like say 2 weeks, then them start her, you know, me just move, I would have think that something was going on.
So negatively, you know, feel said, hold on it, darling. So Carla, you know, feel said possible after 6 months, a year, them get together. Yes, you move on, you know, that's fine. But, you know, feel say the possibility is after 1 year you start them together. You know, feel say it's still possible, say. Them did a go on with that thing while on it together.
Yes, but if them did a go on with it while we was together, then them say we ain't on the earth. I mean, I want to really think that.
Oh.
Don't move on already.
But what go to your mind? You move on and you have your nice, nice, good up husband, right?
I'm going to ask her, I'm going to tell her, you know, because I'm going to say, look here. When you do it from the washing machine, but I do it away there, you know, because so many of them do it, you know?
How are you
saying? I'm not going to
say. What are you saying?
You have to be friends. You see, you are your best friend, you know, you still have to be friends.
Eh?
You have to know with your business where you are. Tell her, because you just, she might go tell him, but.
Yes.
We can't stop it because it's going to be either my husband or fair husband, whichever way I look on it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
so you say, you're going to still friend her. You're not going to still be friend.
Eh?
You're not going to still maintain a friendship.
All right. My best friend right now,
mm-hmm.
I don't think I really want to last our friendship.
Right.
No, I don't think I really want to lose our friendship because of a man.
Right.
Because that it is so thick.
Yes.
I don't know how to put it. That we love each other so much. We are there for each other so much.
That's good.
Understand, we feel the pain. Trust me.
Yes.
It's only a child next.
Yes.
Only a child next.
Wow.
Your best. So I don't really want, because me and that demand the break off, me and she are going to lose relationship. I don't really want that happen.
Okay, real talk.
I don't really want that happen. No.
So you're saying you'd be like Dan Dan and wish her all the best, just the same?
Of course.
Okay.
Of course. Possible to me now, go out of the wedding. I mean, I want she come out of the wedding, because me say it could be that either he, fear, or my husband, whichever one of us.
Yes. Know?
And in life, all we need is a husband to settle down with, and that's the husband for a lifetime. It's just that a person that wasn't for you.
Real talk.
Yeah, it's real talk. It's not, I'm not saying feelings not today now, but you don't move on with Jan over there, so, or Susie over there. So,
yeah, so know? So tell me, like, what could I go through your mind? Even though you move on, like, what would you think would go through people's mind?
I don't know what I'm going to go through for them, man. But if anything will go through my mind, that me I'm going to say, well, possibly I'm going to be friend. I'm going to ask her. They don't mean a friend when we are talking. And she's not going to say yes. She's going to say no. You see? So you're going to get the answer in the one. But all you're going to do is rub little sugar on it and say, dude, and possibly you, she, and him is such a friend.
Yeah.
Because nobody don't know why you and him break off. The problem why you and him break off. Sometimes it can be something serious and it's just some simple little shit. You know?
Mm-hmm.
Start with a friend. But that's it. But, I mean, I don't know. But everybody have a different mind.
Yes, true.
And have different feelings.
And different views.
And that is it. And you use it. But me, I am not the person to just... I don't try to have negative mind.
Real talk. We're up on a break, darling.
All right, Cleon.
Thank you so much for calling. We're over the break, too.
No, I'm in cold front in Portland. Come here, everybody are bad for cold front.
Yes, man, we cold over here bad.
Lord, I'm mad. So no, can imagine poor wee back over here.
I can imagine.
Arthritis, turn up. It's
all right, darling. Thanks for calling.
All right, bye.
Wow. Cool. It's now 4 minutes past 12, guys. The time is brought to us by VJ Print. After 11, sorry. The time is brought to us by VJ Printing Services. And Real Talk is sponsored by Nessal. Stick and stay.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Business operators, local and overseas, this announcement is for you.
Styles FM is an internationally known radio network with worldwide listeners in over 120 countries.
From our studio in Port Antonio, Jamaica, to the ears of the people in your community, our listeners can be your new customers.
Styles FM is an economical, efficient, and effective advertising option for your business.
No matter the size of your business, there's always growth potential. Styles FM provides the customer reach needed to realize that upward movement.
So procrastinate no more. Advertising is a must.
For more details on how to advertise with Styles FM, visit www.stylesfm.com or email info@stylesfm.com or call us on 876-518-2399.
Styles FM, the world listens.
Do you have or are you seeking a place to rent, seeking employment or have a job vacancy? Are you selling a car or having a garage sale? Then come see us. Let Styles do the advertising for you and you'll be on your way in no time. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Advertising style. Advertise with Styles.
Get your Saturday morning started the right way. It's all about the jumpstart with Chungi, the Chinaman on your radio. From 6 a.m. to 9 a.m., it's all about fights from the start to the finish. We're boring a go that get diminished. So whether you're home, on the road, on a bus, or drive taxi then, come listen to Jumpstart on Styles FM. We cover the globe like oxygen.
Easy.
Jumpstart Saturdays, 6 to 9 a.m., that's at the time. Anything else me leave out? Cho, never mind.
For complete auto repairs and services, come to Akon Auto Technology, located at 33 Bumble Crescent, Port Antonio, Jamaica. We offer specialist services in wheel alignment and wheel balancing, brake drum and disc rotary servicing, state-of-the-art ultrasonic cleaning and testing of your fuel injectors. We also stock an assorted range of auto service parts, tires, and motorcraft batteries. If we don't have it, we will source it for you. Call us at 876-715-5205. Or email AkonAutoTech16@gmail.com. Akon Auto Technology, beyond the typical auto mechanic shop.
Native Audio Stage and Lighting, now offering stage, lighting, and truss systems for your small and medium-sized events. Whether it's a stage show, concert, drama play, wedding, street party, or club setting, you name it, we'll bring it to life. Call us at 871-5212 or 844-6531. Native Audio Stage and Lighting, a sponsor of In the Know of the Law with Sergeant Adele Rose Green and also Real Talk with Lady Cleo and Daddy Rude.
The views expressed on this program are not necessarily the views of Native Broadcasting Network or Styles FM.
We're back with you on Real Talk. And of course, we are up on the final hour of the show. So we have more Real Talk right here for you. All right. So we go to the final part of the Vox Pop idea before we go to our little article for tonight. Would you have an issue if your partner chooses your friend as the person he or she confides in? when there is an issue or when there are issues in the relationship. And for me, oh, absolutely, yes, I would have an issue. I've got a problem. Everything that happens, he brings it back to my girlfriend. More men will have an issue with that, with the woman bringing it back to his best friend, than the other way around. But I do believe both sides would have an issue. Because if every single thing that happens, every little issue, you bring it gone to her. What are you saying? You value speaking to her more than you speak value speaking to me? Can you speak to her more than you can speak to me? What are you hoping to achieve by going to her? Does she take your side in the matter that you bring to her every time? Or does she split justice? Does she speak without bias? Or the thing she says to you, does she comfort you so much that you feel drawn and attached to her? Or does she open her mouth and talk things where maybe she shouldn't be talking and telling you? And oh, yes, man, I see me so when she did with so and so and so, and then you come back and smile up with me like me, your friend? Hello? Because they are friends who backbite each other, you know, big and serious, real talk. Both sides too. Male and female do it. And there are some friends who are genuine and honest enough who will say, listen, my honest view is X, Y, and Z. And I don't believe A, B, and C. And you shouldn't whatever, whatever, right? There are people who will be friends to the end and be genuine to their friends. And they won't jump into the person the least chance they get. Because this is the person vulnerable and coming to them to come complain. Now, men, sit down and make a girl talk with you when there is an issue or when there are issues. Because trust me, if it is that she goes to your friend with the issues every time, there are some friends, and I say it without apology, there are some friends who will listen and not say a word or not side with their friend. Nor sad with you. There are some friends who will say, look here, man, I'm not working out, man. Everything good, man. Him love you, man. Him not do this and him not do that. And, you know, just go easy with him, man. You know, say that's so him steam and that's a man thing. And they'll do that. There are friends who will do that. There are friends who will encourage her to just go talk it over with him. But you have some other people. I mean, I'll call them friends. You got have some other people who will badmouth the male and worm their way into getting under that skirt. Big and serious, it happens. Sad to say, but it happens. And then they are actually dealing with the girl only to make a mockery of the situation and make fun about it because they want to know what their friend, what them brethren a sample. They want to sample it too. Some males, I won't call them men. Some males do that. So you gotta be careful. Don't get me wrong. I do think that there are probably some women too who, boy, the man look good. Him hot. Him sexy. And him a come to me, come complain about Susie Q and where she a going with. And you know what? Me a go listen because, boy, him look good. Me can't help but just want him. I'm just thinking about him straight so. And she listens and she listens. And she, some of them too, will badmouth the friend. And make some suggestive statements too. Not coming explicitly and saying out loud exactly what they want to say, but they're giving the man thoughts to read between the lines and to make inferences and draw conclusions. Mm-hmm. Some of them do it for true. While you have some who will split the justice. Some will take sides with the girl or take sides with the male. And some will take sides with the man when they complain in front of him. But behind him and when they go back to the friend, they take the friend's side. Oh boy, two side cutlass. So you really, really got to be careful. And then there are really some friends, some people who are genuine friends who you can really talk to. And they say, you know what? let's have a group meeting and I'm the neutral person and I hear both sides. Because really and truly, there are always really two sides to a story. Sometimes more than two sides, because you have the truth sometimes. His side, her side, and the truth. But be careful how you tell, who you tell, and how much of what you tell on a real talk. But for me, I have a problem. Don't keep going to war with everything. If you're going to go to war or go to him, yeah? If you go to my friend with stuff, how about letting me know you're going to go there? So we can have amicable, or we can have a togetherness where we both hear each other's voices. The back of my thing, you know, I don't know, you can't bring wrong information or misconstrue the whole thing. And then me not hear what you tell her, say. So she gets a particular impression when really and truly that's not what she's supposed to even get. But me being there or you being there, we can now talk it over and dissect the whole thing. And both sides are aired and not just, you know, skewed to fit one particular person. That's my take. Cassidy, are you okay with her going to your bridge and go tell him everything every time one is to come up? She gonna talk to him? What do you say about that? No.
Alright, for me, definitely something like that not gonna work.
Not gonna work for you?
No.
I say your big friend. And you know what your friend would say. Remember?
I know what you would say.
But you don't appreciate her going to him about everything.
But I know that he wouldn't keep up the conversation.
You sure?
For one, I'm 100% sure.
Okay. So you're not going to fret, so maybe more try, you know, inveigle her and comfort her certain ways, you know what I mean? No? You're not afraid about that?
No, me know my
friend. You trust your friend like that?
Me know my friend them like that.
I don't trust nobody so easy, you know? With my things, you know?
That's why I have little to no friends.
Okay. Fair enough.
Yeah, so the ones
choose them wisely.
Yeah, the ones that I do have,
real talk. And big ups to the real friend them out there. Real friend. Chris Martin, sing about them. Yeah? Real talk. But you don't have a problem with her just telling him everything still, even though you know the friend.
She's not supposed to tell him nothing at all.
Okay. What does that do, though? Do you think it makes you too vulnerable or exposes you too much? Exposes your relationship too much?
Mm-hmm.
And you prefer to keep it discreet? As best as possible.
Well, yeah, basically, because suppose last night, you know, we had to look at something and go do something and you don't want him to know, say, I do that something.
True. Oh, Jesus! Prestige! Daddy Rude, I hope you're listening, you know. Do look at something there, and I really want him to say, do look at something there, yeah. And then she got talk, I said, listen, last night, you see, me and Cassidy, and we do this, and you must say, oh, right away, him is him like off, you know. Him not hear nothing more. All him a think about a what? So Cassidy, I go on. Yeah. So, and then you don't know where. Do you think though that the information that she disseminated might go elsewhere?
It's possible. It is possible.
Maybe not deliberately, but it might very well end up somewhere else.
Yeah, it's possible.
Yeah.
Can your friend have a friend? Do you know?
Exactly. I'm glad you said that, because I really and truly. Your friend have a friend for true. And trust me, I have learned that. I've learned that. In years back, I've learned that. Friend of a friend too. So, the males should not be going out there. And there are some men and women who, the more they go and tell the person about the friend, there are things that friend will pick up about the partner. Good and bad. And it could be destructive, because you could very well draw the person to the other person or lead them to the other person in a deeper way. Or it could draw them, run them farther still. But, and then just making an image, giving an image of the person, which is not necessarily a good image, is not a good thing either, because it just might not even be the way the person keep going to the person and bringing it across. Sometimes probably they could very well be the problem, don't it?
That's true. But yeah. Knowing that if you don't know that the kind of person that they are, they can always use it to their advantage.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. And like I said, I know of a case where the man and the man are good friend. Good chatter road and carry on and he was actually meddling with the man's girlfriend, which really and truly she just want two good liquid episode two before, because she should know better. That this man and this man, they are friends. How dare you breach that? Real talk. How dare you breach that knowingly? Even breach that. Because when you don't know, as Charm said, sometimes it's a holy friend ball game. But the moment you are aware of that, how could you just breach that? Yeah, so me not blame no one man for that something there. Me I blame the two of them. Because them no say of them brethren. Me and the guy there. And I'm a brethren, me not look. You know, me not look pan our people like that. Me not, him as the man shouldn't even be looking at the man's in brethren's girl like that. So real talk. That's a whole different level of mess going on right there. But it does happen. It's a real talk. It happens. So, ladies, be careful. And sometimes when you go to the woman them too, it don't make no difference, you know, because, boy, me know we all go to a chick and tell her about the guy. And, you know, she say, I want him, you see. Him body tan good. Round and sexy can done. You understand? So she might be icing him too. So you gotta be careful. Cause chances are you're going to talk about him. You don't want to lose him neither. But depends on what you say and how much you say. It draws her. Makes her antennas go up and ooh la la. This is my chance to go in for the kill. So you come home every night. Every night he won't come about it. Me can't manage him, man. Me tired of it, man. Me tired of him. Last night, tonight, this morning, and it's a guana guanso. And she saying, me dying for one man with this. And the moment she hears that, she could very well just decide to say, look, you know what? You're running pan Cassidy cowboy. Cassidy's a bunny and a geyser. And that's what I want. I want a stula. And she just run in pan it. And all of a sudden, you shock and I wonder, where really are going? When since them 2 years, how comes? She evil, she wicked, she this, she that. And you know the names that they would call each other, right? So, you got to be careful. All right? You got to be careful, Cassidy.
Very.
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 Very, very careful. Real talk. Let's go back to the Vox Pop for a minute there, because we're going to be wrapping that up right now, guys. We do have something else to share with you. So, for those people who have no objections, there are some who will argue until they say, look, the fact that my husband, me love him so dearly, and I love my girlfriend dearly, I know nothing if it were them link up after me pass and gone. The better way of that. Because at least me know say she taking care, him taken care of by a nice girl, that me no know where him end up. That's the view of some people. And another view, like many of us, me no care when me pass and gone, if them want get on, fine. But me not sanction that before me pass. Sorry. Be real talk. And of course, part two on X is an X. And of course, some people will make you believe, oh, sure, X are X, I'm going to move on long time. There are people who have moved on long time. And there are some who, no matter what, some things will still linger and some things will still affect them. So there are some, seeing the X with another friend, with a friend, oh, please, no big deal. She wants him, fine. But for some, my ex and my friend, you must be mad. That'll kill me. Real talk, we're on air. Good night, caller. Welcome.
Good night, Cleo. How you doing?
Hi, Marvin. I'm good. How you doing?
I'm all right, I guess.
You sound so down.
Huh?
You sound puny.
Yeah.
Hush, my dear.
But about the question about the... What was the question again about... If your partner, would you...
Yes, if you would have a problem, you know, with your partner and your friend getting it on, getting intimate.
Being that I'm dead, no. Because, listen, if all of my friends that I do, the few friends that I do have, respect me and know, hey, this, you know what I mean, this is how he is. You know what I mean? He doesn't like this, he doesn't like that. So, point blank period, they would know there's a line and they would know where to draw that line.
Okay, real talk. But there are some people who don't, sad to say.
Yeah, that part is true, but for me, it's just all about respect, you know what I mean?
Real
some
talk.
Some people wouldn't care, some people would.
Right.
You know what I mean? In my case, personally, I know it wouldn't happen because I know the type of friends that I have.
Right.
You know what I mean? I know what they know what I would, if I would get mad, they know what I like, what I don't like. You know what I mean? We both know. I know everything about them, they know everything about me. So certain things, you know what I mean, I wouldn't even do. I would even think about doing it. Because I know it would make them mad.
Real you know talk.
I mean? Now, in a case like that, I mean, I wouldn't even have to worry about stuff like that because I know it wouldn't happen, period.
Fair enough.
And what was that? The other part?
The second part. Cassie, they bring up back the second part for me. So the second part of the Vox Pop is really about the ex. And whether or not you're going to feel no way, say your ex and your best friend hook up. Whether it's a long, your ex is from a long time ago or more recent times, would it really matter? But would you matter that they're together now? That gonna affect you? That gonna make you feel no way? What go through your mind?
I again, it all boils down to respect.
Yes.
So, me, if one of my friends, you know what I mean, I wouldn't dare think about being married. Even if she come on to me, I wouldn't even think about that.
Yeah, you know even what I mean? She, hold on to Marvin.
Blank, and then, yeah.
Yeah, even if she come on to you, I wouldn't make it happen. But what if you and her spark a fire, my yo? The fire lick off between the two of you. The chemistry turn up. What you try to tell me? So you're not going to fight the feelings?
Well, it wouldn't get that far because I wouldn't allow it to get that far.
True. But how do you determine who you're naturally drawn to? We not get that.
And then number two.
Eh?
Remember, not because we are friends, meaning they see the type of girl that I would.
But chances are they do too.
So maybe that person, that female is not even my type.
But what if she is? And I can't fight this feeling anymore.
To be honest, I've never been in that predicament before.
A predicament for true, my love.
You know what I mean? We're friends, and you know my wife, blah, blah, blah. But me and my wife, you know how long my wife is. Those are my friends. Yeah, I'm still going to talk and drink and hang out and all that kind of stuff.
Nah.
I mean? So they will know about her. They will see her. If we all meet up together, you know what I mean? They would talk to her or whatever, not. But yeah. That's about it.
Okay.
And they know, then again, they know there's a thin line. So,
real talk. Like so your friends
and
know.
I wouldn't disrespect them.
Right? So, your friends know the boundaries, and so do you.
Yeah, I mean.
Because we got to set boundaries.
Yeah, real friends is hard to find enough.
True.
And I'm not going to make the cause of some. Just like when they say friends come and go, female comes and go.
Mm.
And if, like, the three friends that I have right now, we've been friends for about 19, 20 years.
Mm-hmm.
So, we're not going to make, because of some foolishness, you know what I mean? We in an argument or whatever, no. You know what I mean?
But you know that there's some.
What?
Yes, huh? Go ahead.
Them know what pissed me off. I know what pissed them off. It's just all about respect.
Real talk.
Them like that. And there's no way they can call you my friend. And you don't diss me like that. Or never diss me like that. And obviously we was a friend.
Real talk. Next part of the Vox Pop, though, is would you have an issue?
Right.
Would you have an issue if your girlfriend or your wife were to choose to confide in your best friend? Every time you have an issue in a relationship, she gonna talk to the guy about it.
Yes, she gonna get that back in her face.
How are you, say, man?
Nah, but real. But I'm not serious. You know what?
But are your friend?
None of my friends. Mm. I don't want none of my friends in my relationship. Not one.
Real talk.
If me and my girl have a problem, we work it out like two adults. Because you may go to my friend and my friend tell you something where it's so good, and you act on it, and we break up.
Yes.
So any issues we have at all, we see that we talk about it like that. There's no going to no friend, no going to no mother, no father, no nothing.
There's real talk.
Me and you in a relationship.
Real talk.
It. We work out with stuff. We sit and we talk about with stuff. You know what I mean? If we need local counseling, yeah. But it won't be somebody who...
Take one side.
Your friend. Nah, I wouldn't be none of that. Kind
yeah.
Of
real talk.
This is why some people relationship won't work because they talk too much.
Right. Real talk.
So, I'm just like you were saying, what if I stop, you know what I mean, some little simple stuff with men or adults with men or my friends.
I tell your boy.
You will go say, oh, yeah. And
yes.
Nah.
And you did that hide it long okay. time with your friend, them, don't it?
And the issue we have, we'll talk about that.
Real talk.
I'm not going to know friend or nothing.
Real talk.
All right.
All right, Marvin. Thank you so much.
Okay. All right.
All right. I'm glad he called in. I was wondering where he was. All right. It's now 11:30, and the time is brought to us by VJ Printing Services and Native Entertainment, Stage Audio and Lighting. They are the sponsors of Real Talk. Stick around. We soon give you more after the break.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Don't miss the adrenaline rush with the musical ingenious Digital T. Saturdays, right here on Styles FM from 4 to 8 p.m. Remember the uprising artists and new music segment from 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. Also mixed journal hour from 6 to 7 p.m. And the party hour from 7 to 8. Come, Styles FM. Digital T. Our brain.
Planning a party, club night out, stage show, a gospel concert, or even a business sales event? Let Styles FM be a part of your promoting tool. Take advantage of our low-priced promotion packages with commercials, interviews, giveaways, reviews, and much more. We have special offers when you mix and match and bundle your options. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Styles FM, for the most effective way to exploit your marketing dollar.
Guess what? Styles FM has a new business number for you to call, text, and now WhatsApp. 518-2399. To advertise your business and events, call, text, or WhatsApp us on
518-2399. 518-2399.
Don't forget, 518-2399.
Welcome back to Real Talk, guys. We, of course, about to close out the Vox Pop. And, of course, Marvin called in and gave his view just before the break. So we thank everyone who represented for the Vox Pop tonight. Appreciate it so very, very much. For those who wouldn't have an issue with your friend talking to your friend because of the relationship that you share, to each his own, because there are persons who will tell you, oh, whenever I go to the friend with issues, I get good advice that can come back and build and mend the relationship. Yeah? But for those who it works for, yeah, do your thing. For those who think it's just a recipe for disaster, then please don't get engaged in that. Find another way of resolving your issues together. However, I must admit and tell you, if it becomes a case where it is violent, then not try to find a friend for me, nothing. Because violence really normally lead to one other parties losing their life. It usually leads to that. All right, so you have to know when to call it quits and when to call a spade and when to cut. All right, and stop trying to fix some things. Real talk. All right, but what can be fixed? What can be mended? By all means, do your very best to mend it. All right, you will know when the red flags go up. All right, guys, so tonight we look at 23 must-know relationship advice for women by Ethan Kent. All right, 23 must-know advice for women. Love isn't complicated or painful. Well, it's not supposed to be, right? In fact, it's effortless, or it should be effortless. Operative words are should. As long as you keep these 23 must-know tips and relationship advice for women in mind. Are you having a hard time in love? Do you find yourself getting frustrated by your man to no end? Or do you worry your man isn't into you the way he once was? It's funny, isn't it? Women want perfect romance. Men want perfect romance. And yet, somehow, most men and women just don't seem happy when they come together to create the romance. It starts off perfectly, just like they say it would in fairy tales. It's all bliss and romance for a good year or two, and then things just start to change. And that perfect romance you once found just vanishes into thin air right before your eyes. Have you experienced that? Well, it's never too late to change your romance stars and bring love and happiness back into your life. Must know relationship advice for women. Ladies, are you awake? Are you listening? If you're still dating, well, you're not in a committed relationship yet. So you can use the Love Banky Dating Girls code to help you get off to the perfect start. Uh-huh. All right. But if you're in a committed relationship, read on, because these must-know relationship advice could help you, and it really could change your life for the better. The one big relationship tip all girls need to know. Many women say they try hard, but they just can't make relationships work. A few others say they had no idea when the relationship started to go bad. But in reality, all of us know what we need to do to fix a relationship all the time. But we procrastinate, assume the effort is just not worth the hassle, or we're too egotistic to bend over. Yeah, man, some people really are. It's all about them, and they don't see themselves trying to fix a problem. How many of them create it, right? So if you really want your relationship to work out, just keep one piece of advice in mind. Trust your instincts. It's as simple as that. If you feel like something's not right, in all probability, the chances are really, ladies or gentlemen, something is definitely wrong. Communicate and make the effort. At times, the relationship may be a failed cause because your man's a bad guy. But almost always, the relationship stagnates because you and your lover have started to take the relationship for granted. That is a real talk. Unapologetically, many times why things go bad is one or the other party take things for granted, or both. Take each other for granted. 23 relationship tips for a better love life. If you're looking for relationship advice for women, just keep these 23 tips in mind. I'll help you experience better relationships and have a better love life too. Here we go with number one. Play with him, ladies. Play with the man. And we not only mean lie down and tickle and kick. I mean like, play with your man. Flirt with your man. Yeah? Go in that room, put on something sexy, hot, and flirt with your husband. Play with your husband. Yeah, man? Romp. Run him down through the house. Make him run him down through the house. I know something. Playfulness is the one thing that holds a happy relationship together more than anything else. Just because you're past your childhood doesn't mean you should act all grown up all the time. A true. That straight face and stiffness just really boring. On a serious note, I love to laugh. I love to play. I ramp like puppy all the time. It makes you relax sometimes from a hard, stressful adult life, man. Yeah, relax, unwind. Two, men are easily influenced by other men around them in their life. If his friends and other guys in the room think you're a dream catch, he'll fall more in love and stay more in love with you and avoid straying away from you. So convince him as to why he should stick around. Three, not all men understand the art of chivalry, romantic gestures, and romance. Instead of giving up on him, show him the way by example and he'll learn to treat you with respect. Yeah? So ladies, teach him a thing or two, no? Because trust me, despite what these men think, right, Cassidy? We women can teach uno a thing or two sometimes too. Real talk. Four, listen to his point of view. This is very, very serious, ladies. Nothing is more bruising to a man's ego than when a woman makes him feel like him can't, him not a viewpoint. Him not have nothing to say, we're worthwhile. Trust me, you crush him like you crush one roach. Now do it. Bruise him up bad, bad, bad. Listen to his point of view before arguing back or cutting across him. It's the easiest way to prevent tempers from rising. And don't be condescending either. No, I hate that word, you see, man, because boy, when people condescend with me, me don't like it at all. It's not nice. Putting you down and making you feel less than is not a nice feeling at all. And I know tempers will flare and you'll have arguments and you'll have your strong points. Like sometimes me hold on my strong points and me just strong will and stubborn sometimes, yes. But try your best, ladies, not to be condescending at all and to let him have a voice. Even when you disagree, say, okay, dear. Okay. I'm in a sarcasm, I'm not really sure it somewhat, but just say, okay, dear, I hear you. All right? Five, you can't change someone. Real talk. Who doesn't want to be changed? Or I should say, you can't change someone who doesn't want to be changed. Real talk. Help your man understand you better and help him learn by example. But if he doesn't want to change for you, perhaps he doesn't respect you or care enough for you and you need someone else who can love you for who you are. But of course, bearing in mind that if there are some little issues that need to change and to work on, then you really ought to introvertedly try to work on those too. Because really and truly, we're not perfect. We have issues, yeah, that will affect the other person. So we can do our introspections at times too. Real talk. Number six, don't constantly remind him of his past failures. Lord, that crush him up too. Men are very sensitive when it comes to past mistakes. He'll clam up like a shell if you use his past failures to get him to accept defeat or listen to you. True. Past failures kill anybody, both male and female. Don't keep bashing them about what they did in the past. It's not a nice feeling. They'll resent you for it. Seven, don't blame yourself. You're never entirely at fault if the relationship starts to suffer. So don't blame yourself completely if you're experiencing a bad relationship. Accept responsibilities, but don't blame yourself unless it really is your fault. And I make the other person put all the blame on you either. Because I always think that no relationship just broke up so because of one person alone. Right? Sometimes when you look at it deeper, there are some issues that are happening that cause it to go bad from both sides, really and truly. Eight, men can't read minds. As convinced as you are that men should have the innate, the natural ability to read a woman's mind, they really can't. Ladies, do wake up. They really can't. So speak your mind and he will listen to your thoughts. Let's hope so. Number nine, no guy likes a drama queen. Especially if she goes looking for ways to complicate the relationship. Oh, yes. That one will make any man run for cover. Call your mama. Save your mama. They're going to run far, far, far. The drama queens with the baby father dramas, and all kind of other dramas, they are going to run for cover. Yeah. Number 10, the silent treatment. Ignoring your boyfriend when he hurts you may seem like the best way to teach him a lesson. But truth be told, the silent treatment won't make him stop hurting you. It only make him a better liar. Ouch. That one hurts. Reality check. Number 11, you and your partner are a team. There are no winners or losers between partners. True, true. Either both of you will win or both of you will lose together. So any issue has to be worked out. To better the relationship, not to win points. Real talk. If it really means something to you, then it also you will make a compromise to make it work. Real talk. Men think they hate high maintenance women. Ha! This is interesting. Let me get that one. Great. But that's exactly the kind of girl they secretly desire. I would love for men to call to tell me right now if that's true. Marvin, is that true? Dan, is that true? Men think they hate high maintenance women, but that's exactly the kind of girl they secretly want. I wonder if it's a case where they secretly want the high maintenance girl who will be maintaining herself. Daddy Rude. I think that's a Daddy Rude speech right there. Yeah. He has no problem with that high maintenance woman, but once she's able to maintain herself, he's good with that. Right, Daddy Rude? Yes, Cassidy, I know you shake your head. Yes, man, I know. Once you can hold our own, him good. All right. Well, I think I fall in that category. Yeah. 13. Love is a complex blend of physical attraction and emotional attachment for men. Make a man realize that he needs you emotionally before he sees all of you sexually. Real talk. Woy-oy. And when he gets that, ladies, keep him wanting more. 14. Every guy loves a girl who's a lady on the street and you know what in the sheet. But it says bed, but it rhymes more with sheet, right? And that's a fact. Number 15, love is full of layers. Take time to fall in love and experience the relationship one step at a time. Sweet Jesus. Rushing too soon or moving in together too soon can make him think twice about his commitment to you even before he is really fallen in love. Number 16, don't let yourself go. If you're in a long-term relationship. Sexual attraction plays a big part in a happy romance. Work out and look your best if you want your man to desire you more than he desires any other woman. But do your best, ladies. That's all I'm going to say. Do your best. Because really and truly, if you work out like Lisa Hannah, who is looking gorgeous, by the way, and him still wants to go out there, he's going to. So really and truly. But if it is that, you know, you can keep yourself in tip-top shape, do your best you can. If you can't do anything else, just leave the rest. Because really and truly, it should be who you are that has fallen in love with and not what you look like so much. Because if he gives you all these babies and the babies put on the fat on you and you can't get it off, then when going to run leave you? No. You stay right there. Real talk. All right? So don't let yourself go. But what I mean is don't look all pop down and mash up. Yeah, because you're with him now. Keep yourself in shape as best as you can. Wear the nice clothes. Do your hair. Yeah. Go do your pedicure when you're ready. I don't know. Something. Come on. really nice body massage and, you know, yeah. 17, insecurity woes. Don't let your insecurities get the better of you. Sex appeal is all in your mind and how you project yourself. Because trust me, but a fisa is a small waist, big hips and big butt. Ladies, with a vital, you know, stats, like perfect, quote unquote perfect, alone can be sexy. I saw a lady who is a plus size on a pole in a video once. And she was entering some competition. And she was up on that pole. And my ear them open wide. I wonder if it's really a plus size lady, this, on a pole. I know some slim persons who can't even go climb the pole halfway up. And she was up on that pole doing some real fancy creative stunts with her body. And she did stay good. You know? So I'm saying that to say, hello, don't let insecurities get the better of you. Whatever you're good at, you work it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Praise him for his achievements, even if it's small. He'll try harder all the time just to win your praise. It's true. Nobody no love praise like a man. Not even the children don't love praise as much as a man loves to be praised. In a little achievement, in a little thing he does that you think was, wow, tell him, oh, baby, that's good. That looks good. That was fabulous. You were awesome. Yes, man. I want something small. Make him feel really nice. And you're not going to say it because you want some of my money or whatever, you know. Oh, yeah, look, something. Make him really feel good if he really did something nice or something simple. Number 19. Don't try too hard to please your man. I wonder what I mean by this one now. If your gestures aren't reciprocated, so don't try too hard to please your man if your gestures aren't reciprocated. I may agree with that one here. Sorry. So if you are do, and I give, and I try please, and the man ain't doing nothing. He's not doing one earthly thing in return to show his appreciation or any little thing to show that, you know what, let me show in return how I feel about her too. Then, master, what you try for? What you continue to try for? Eh? You're what? What are you really now? Which era circle of a place that you can go get buried when you die, when you do all these great things? Seriously. So give as much as you're going to receive. That's one of the problems with some of us. We give so much that and we're not getting anything in return, and then we really can't deal with it. Right? So he just take you for granted. Instead, make him realize just how lucky he is to have you. Most guys just take things for granted instead of realizing how lucky they are. And that is true. And you know what? In all honesty, vice versa too. Some women take things for granted too. And we shouldn't. 20. A man needs his space. Even if he doesn't ask for it, as long as he's by himself or with his guy friends, you really have nothing to worry about. Sorry. Where am I? In fact, it'll help both of you love each other better. It's true, they want a space. You go have a drink. Go hang with them friend. I don't know. Go fuck them eye too. All these things happen. Some of them. But the point is, give him space and let him feel like he can always go and have some fun with his friends without you calling. Where you there? You not come home. You soon come. And start to nag, right? But of course, the trust must be built. That's the next thing too. Because when no trust is there, trust me, you can't guarantee she's going to nag you. And call your phone. Right? 21. Get kinky! A relationship needs to evolve all the time. And so does sexual intimacy. If you think your sex life is starting to get predictable or boring, try something new every now and then, right, Cassidy? Yeah. Talking dirty is a great way to kickstart your sexual adventure. Okay. So married women, Christian married women who the husband is yours. Hello. He is yours. The bed is undefiled. Yeah, get it on. All right, 22. Don't knee him below the belt. Using sarcasm or snide comments. If he feels helpless or emotionally violated, he'll stop communicating with you. 23 and last, be his shoulder to lean on. Women, be that person the man you're with can really rely on. Right? In the roughest of times, be that person he can confide in, he can talk with, can relate to. Every day you're sick. How are you, sir? Yeah. You can't stay in here. I mean, I have no money. And if you have no money, you can't stay. No. Be the shoulder he can lean on. And when him have the money and him arty, you get it. When him not have none, work it out now. Work it out. Because when he has it, he's there for you. Don't turn your back on him because him don't have no money now. Not nice. Karma! As macho as he seems, he's almost always a child who needs a woman's love to give him emotional strength. Real talk. These tips could seem pleasantly easy to follow, but as you read these relationship advices, do you really think you are following all these tips in your own love life? Use these 23 must-know relationship advice for women, and you'll be able to create a better romance for yourself and your man. After all, experiencing a perfect romance doesn't have to be as hard as most people think it is. Real talk. And wow. Very, very interesting here for us women. And I trust that my ladies have heard it all. And I trust that the men who heard it all will also remind their girls and their wives and their ladies, hey, you didn't hear them? Well, let's go back and watch the show on YouTube. Let's bring it back to that part where Cleo spoke about the things that the ladies them must learn and must know to do to enhance them relationships. And I trust men picked up on a few tips of their own from the article. Thank you guys so very much for being a part of the show tonight. We have come pretty much down to the wire, to the end of it. And gonna say on behalf of my engineer Cassidy, really and truly, who held it down with me tonight, oh, thank you so much. All our persons, our callers who called in, Dan, big up yourself. Charmy, all the Vox Poppers, everybody who called in, the young lady who called in there too earlier. Thank you guys so very much for keeping my company throughout the night. All those persons who text in, we have some texts coming in, Cassidy. Let's get those texts quickly before we go. I didn't realize that we had some more texts there. Sorry. It's a wonderful, blessed. Only one I would really comment on. Most of these Christian ladies is married to the church and their pastor. Sorry. We'll talk. Okay. Let's see what is there, Cassidy. Oh boy. Hold on. We get more from Wilton there. Go back to Wilton, please. That's unfortunate. Where am I? No matter who you are, definitely. Okay, read that one already. Sorry. All right, let's move on to somebody else quickly. Let's see. 520, could I have your name, please? Some of them tips there will work, but some don't. Don't try them. It depends on who your partner is. Let's see who else is there, Cassidy. Do we have some persons on the Facebook Live? Could I shout them out, you know? All the Facebook Live people big up on themselves. All right. I was calling and couldn't get through. I don't know what happened, honey. So sorry. 561. Well, guess what? The next time, call again, okay? I'm not sure what happened there, but I didn't get the calls coming in at all. Sorry. Who else we have there, Cassidy? That's it? All right, good night. Kimoy, Sunning Hill. Oh, checked in a little bit late. All right, guess what, Kimoy? See the show tomorrow on YouTube, all right? And tell me what you think next week. All right, so Cleo, signing out with our friend Cassidy, my engineer tonight. Yeah, pick up yourself, Daddy Rude. Pick up yourself, Prestige. I'll forgive you guys by next week for leaving me alone tonight. But I was in good company with Cassidy, of course. Charm. Oh, I see. Okay. All right. Thanks for the name. And on behalf of everybody here at Stars, and of course, the Real Talk crew, hey, love each other. Treat each other as if it's the last day you got together. Yeah? Love your neighbors. Love your friends. Love your family. Pray for your enemies. And of course, treat each other as if it's the last day. Because remember, we are not promised tomorrow. All those who are losing, who have lost loved ones, again, we pray your blessing and your strength, guidance every time. Be careful on the roads. Have yourselves a great weekend. Until I see you again next time, big up Daddy Rude and his family for life. Lady Cleo signing out. Bye-bye.